Hello, YouTube community. It's me again, Silver Horse. It's my second video. I'm officially addicted. There's no 12-step program. Just let it go. So I'm going to go ahead and do the 16 witchy questions tag I saw on Noah Tempestari's video. And so I'm going to go ahead and do it myself. And basically, I'm just going to tag y'all. Y'all tagged. You see this? You tagged. So let's begin. And I'm going to try to keep this, like I said, as short as possible. You know, I'm going to try. All right. So first question is, do you have a witchy name and how did you come by it? So my witchy name is Silver Horse. I've had it since the beginning. And basically, it came to me because silver to me is the metal that I wear. All my jewelry is silver. Except for, you know, a wedding band or anything was white gold, so it could match my silver, but for the most part, silver is it. For me, silver represents the moon, so I'm very tied to that metal, and so silver came out of that. And horse, because I'm a horse nut, I am so connected to horses that it's crazy. From what my mom told me, since I was able to recognize a horse at about 18 months old, I have been infatuated by horses. And throughout my life, I have ridden horses, trained horses, doctored horses, you know, you name it. I've been around horses my entire life. Horses are my totem animal. And my relationship with horses is if like they're not pets. You know, my horse, the picture that you see on my page here with me on the Palomino, her name is Marigold. You know, she was my companion, my best friend. So, Silver Horse. Where are you located? What brought you to your area, or were you born here? I was born in Ontario, Canada. I lived in Canada for 28 years, and then I moved to the States originally to come and visit my fiance's mom to see what I was marrying into, and decided to stay. I loved it here. I actually went from Ontario to Oregon originally, and then we came to Texas. That's where I'm at right now. I'm in Texas. I'm just outside of El Paso, Texas, and we moved here, you know, for the most part, because Texas had a lot of good jobs, and I'm getting old, and I can't handle the cold anymore. So we live in the desert. It gets chilly here in the summer, in the wintertime, but we don't really get snow very much, and it doesn't really stay cold very long, so I can physically handle it a lot better. So, sucks getting old sometimes, so that's why I'm here. Plus, I love the desert. I just love it here. Do you wear special amulet or jewelry for spell work? No. I don't have any special jewelry for spell work. I wear all the time. Like here I wear, this is what I wear all the time. And basically it's a silver necklace. It has my pentagram on it. And then this is pretty hard to see. I don't know if you can see it, but it's three horses and Celtic knot. This is actually my matron and patron's symbol, and it's actually on the back here on the wall. It's that symbol, because that's a bigger one, so you can probably see it a lot clearer. That's the symbol, and one of the questions is about the matron and patron, so I'll go into that detail a little bit later. Okay, what is your favorite space or place? My house, my whole house, my yard, my property. I love my home. My home, I work very hard at home. Again, like I said in my previous video, I'm a hermit and I'm home all the time. My home is my sanctuary. My home is refuge. My office where I work in my witchy room is all in one. Like my altars, as you can see behind me, behind this camera is the desk that I work at when I'm doing my work throughout my paycheck. So, you know, in the front room, you know, I have witchy stuff everywhere. I have altars all over the place. I probably have like 7 or 8 altars around my house. And so my whole house is my favorite place. I meditate in my bedroom. Sometimes I'll meditate in the front room. I mean, every place in my house is very, very calm. And a lot of people that come over to my home that don't even really know what I do, they say that coming here is so quiet and zen-like, I should have one of those zen rock cardings in my living room. So it's very peaceful. Everybody loves it here. What is your favorite stone or crystal for magical workings? So if I'm doing magical workings, I don't really have a favorite stone. I use whatever stone I feel called to use during that particular spell. But the one stone that I use a lot of, and I show and tell time. Let me get it here. Okay. This is a snowflake obsidian sphere. So you can see it's got a little bit of the snowflake in it, just ever so little. It's mostly black. But this crystal I have with me all the time. And you can see it's a good hefty size rock. It's a good hefty size sphere. I use this mostly for meditation. When I'm meditating, I use this, you know, if it's for protection. It helps keep my mind focused on, you know, not always going to the negative, because I tend to have a really bad habit. Okay, gotta learn how to talk. I have the worst habit of kind of looking at the negative side of things. So when I'm meditating, sometimes my meditation can go a little negative. So this really keeps me on the positive path and protects. And I'm very, very connected to, I mean, I always have it, and I'm always playing with it, even at work. It's always with me. So that's my favorite one. Okay, how long have you been practicing, and how did you come to this path? Okay. I started into the witchcraft when I was about 22, 23. So it was about 19 years ago, 20 years ago. Before that, I was never raised in a very religious family. My mom was Christian, but we didn't go to church. We didn't have crosses around. We didn't pray, nothing like that. We were raised in a very follow your own path kind of home. So, but all my life, I've always been very connected to the earth, trees. I was always, you know, outside, always, even when I was a teenager. I didn't like going to the mall. I liked to go to the forest. I liked to go on hikes. I liked to do, you know, I was always in nature. And around my early 20s, I was, you know, I really felt like I needed to find something. Something was missing, and spiritualism was, I think, I felt that that's what it was. So I did the research. In my hometown, they have like Catholic cathedrals and, you know, Jewish, you know, and Christian. I looked at everything. Nothing fit at all. So I actually went online. I got my first computer. That's how long ago it was. And internet. And I started doing research, just punching in things that I believed. And it came up with Wicca originally. Very popular, obviously. And so I started to do more research, and, you know, I found that was, you know, pretty much, it really kind of fit. It was a little off on some things, but the fact that it said you believe what you believe, you know, take what you want and leave other things, I thought this is perfect. So I found a mystic bookshop, I found some books, I did a lot of research, and then I reached out online, actually found somebody that lived like right around the corner from me. She was fantastic. We met up, we started talking. I met more through her because she was a witch already. And then through her, we met another witch, and the three of us made a coven, and then it kind of exploded from there. So that's how I came to the path. And I mean, I love it. I love being a witch. Okay. Do you have a deity, god or goddess, and how do you connect with them? So this is, again, my symbol here. So it's a little bit difficult because I know a lot of people say about Hecate. Hecate recently came to me just to kick my butt back to the path. And again, I'll do a whole video on how I left and came back, because it's going to take a while. But coming back to the path from Christianity, Hecate came to me. And she was like, you're on the wrong path. You're going to get off it, whether you like it or not. And I'm going to kick you, and you're going to trip. You're going to fall. You're going to fall on your face, but you're going to thank me for this. So she did. Anybody who's ever worked with Hecate knows that nothing comes easy with her. But again, you come out a much stronger and more determined person because of it. And so she actually really pushed me, you know, came to me and really pushed me to get back on the witch path. Then once I started walking the path and really getting, you know, yes, this is me and I'm here, she kind of went away. I still have a picture of her, and I thank her every time I see the picture. I thank her. She's still very, very important to me. I don't work with her, But I do appreciate what she did, and I know what she was doing, and you know, so I stay in contact. You know, I just basically, you know, thanking her and paying homage. Now, for my personal matron and patron, obviously with horses, is Epona. And when I was with Epona, I realized when I started meditating and really connecting with her, she came to me directly. Like when I was meditating, she came right up to me and was like, you know, guess what? We're working together. And then I'm always one for balance. I like balance. So man, woman, female, male. And so I was like, oh, I still feel like, you know, something's missing. And so Epos came out. And the one thing I love about my matron and patron, Epona and Epos, is there isn't a whole lot written about them. Now, Epona does have some things. If you look for it, there are some things that are written about her, and there's some statues and things like that. But Epos, there's nothing on him. I think the most I ever found on him was two sentences, and basically the lover of Epona. So I love the fact that there's not a whole lot out there. So I'm not, you know, itching to buy a book and read somebody else's opinion on who these gods are, this god and goddess is, and who they represent. So they basically work with me directly, and I learn from them directly from them. I don't read a lot on them. What I feel, they're, you know, what they're showing me, what they're telling me about them, you know, is how I connect with them. I meditate. You know, they are the god and goddess, you know, of healing, obviously of horses. Sorry, my cats decided they're going to start fighting over here. You two, get out of there. Come on. Loki, come here. You know, healing, horses, the underworld, you know, there's a lot to them, a lot more to them than a lot of people know. So I work with them on that occasion. Loki, what are you doing? I know a lot of people go, you don't have a familiar. Familiar is this, familiar is that. This is my familiar. This is Loki, my troublemaker. And he is definitely my familiar. And it's not because he follows me around, because he does. I think he was raised by chihuahuas, the way he acts. But he does add to my magic. He really does add to my magic. I'm literally surrounded by animals right now. I've got a cat here, babysitting another cat over here, and I have my baby cat over here. So, and my dog is out in the living room somewhere. She'll probably come in here shortly. So that's Epona and Epos. What is your favorite incense or smudge? So for me, incense, pretty much anything. But I like, the Dipper has one. It's cedar and saffron. Lady Grave Dancer was the one that, you know, showed that, and I do love it. You know, of course, there's the white, again, show and tell. You have your white sage that you can see I've used quite a bit of mine, white sage. But I also use, this is white sage with lavender. That way, when I use it, it clears the energy, you know, as white sage clears the energy and opens up and raises the vibrations. The lavender is more for the protection and for the love. And then, of course, this is Palo Santo. And Palo Santo is an amazing smelling wood when you burn it. And this here, once I do my cleansings with these, I use my Palo Santo, and I basically do my symbols over my doors and my windows for extra protection, as well as healing, you know, stuff like that that you're doing in your house. So that's what I use those for. Hopefully they don't fall here. Okay. Made a mess. Oh, well. Other incenses I like, dragon's blood, frankincense, myrrh smells really good for me. I like myrrh. They tend to be the most, you know, the most that I burn. And Nag Champa is another one that I really like. I want to try that temple incense. I haven't tried that yet, but I want to try that. Have you ever had to clear a space of a negative entity? No. Not personally. I do cleanse all spaces that I move into. I live. This place has been cleansed multiple times. I've gone into places that had negative feelings that I've, you know, cleansed simply, but I've never had any real negative, like anything I had to battle. Not yet. I'm not afraid of them. I don't hear spirits. I don't see spirits. That's one thing a lot of people talk about, how they hear them and they see them. I'm like, oh, I wish. I don't. I'm what they call, if I can pronounce it properly, is clairsentience. Basically, my intuition tells me, I just know things. It's in my mind. It's like I'm thinking it already. It's not like I hear a voice in my head or anything like that. It's just, I know. And I have a ghost in my house. His name's Robert. He's protector of my home. He's an old cowboy that was here, you know, being that I'm outside of El Paso. I'm sure I've got a cowboy here. And whenever he's communicating, I just know things, you know. Robert's upset, or, you know, Robert's happy, or Robert's going to do something because he likes to mess with people, especially people who don't think that he's here. He's even got an agnostic saying hi to him when she comes over. That's how he is. So, and he's awesome. I love him. Okay. What is your favorite witchy show or movie? Show and tell. I have a lot. Okay, so 15 minutes. I got to hurry up. So favorite movies, obviously, are the old standbys. So you've got Practical Magic, my all-time favorite. This is the one I watch when I'm depressed and I just want to eat chocolate. That's what I watch, Practical Magic. This thing has been worn out. I think this is my second one. Mists of Avalon is another one that I love. Very, very good. Very, very good. And then, of course, The Craft. Okay, kind of weird, but I like it. It's you're probably seeing that backwards, but it's my camera. So those are the ones that I mainly watch. So this one here, some people like, some people don't. I like it because it's the way historically the Puritans thought what was going on, and it's kind of a weird one. But The Witch, and again, I'm sorry, this is kind of going backwards because my camera, but it's called The Witch. I can see there's a goat on there. Black goat. But it's a unique one. I mean, I have to say, not you either like it or you hate it. I like it. So if you don't like it, it's you. Shows, Charmed. I watched Charmed when it was originally on TV first airing. Old. Watched it every week, and then after that, got it, rewatch it, Netflix to death. Then this one here, I don't hear anybody really talk about. This one is called The Good Witch. Okay, again, sorry, it's backwards. Good Witch. And there's a couple. These are movies. The Good Witch has movies, and she also, on Hallmark, they actually have the series now. And this one is, I like it. It's one of those warm and fuzzies. It's really, really, really good. It really puts witches in a good light. And it doesn't have a lot of the theatrical witchcraft, you know? It's more, to me, if I was going to say a movie that's closest to the real witchcraft as possible, Good Witch is closest to the to real witchcraft as possible. So, just saying. Okay, what do you do to help raise energy before spell work? Basically, I do the same thing for grounding, and I do to bring up energy. I just do it differently. I basically sit lotus style on the floor, and then I imagine roots going down into the earth all the way to the core, pulling up that fiery core, and then I have branches going up from my head to the moon or to the sun, depending on what I'm doing and what energy I want, and I'm bringing that energy in, and as I bring it to my core, I, you know, basically it swirls, and then through my hands, I feel the energy, like energy spheres in my hands. And then I do my spell, and then when I'm done my spell work, I do the same, but instead of pulling the energy in, I basically release the energy. So if I have any extra energy left over, I give it back. As I'm thanking the earth, the moon, and the sun for what, how I've got it. I also listen to music during it, but I don't use music necessarily to build up that energy. When I'm cleansing my home to break up the energy so I can help cleanse it out, I do crank up Celtic drums because I'm a traditional Celtic witch, and I'll put on my Celtic drums, crank her up on my surround sound system, and just boom, boom, the house. So that's how I take care of energy in my house. Do you see yourself helping others magically? I'm going to try. I'm still trying to get back into the whole gig of it myself, but I can definitely help with answering questions. So if you have any, comments below. You can ask me questions and I'll answer you to the best of my ability. I would love to be able to help, you know, those who are just coming to the craft or those who just have questions and I can help. I definitely do that. I recently just had, believe it or not, some good friends of mine who are Catholic feel that they have some bad mojo in their home. So I'm going to be booking some time to go and cleanse their house, as well as a neighbor of mine, helping them out as well. Most times magically what I do is I make a lot of lotions and soaps and, you know, just like everybody else, crafty stuff that we can I basically do to give people, to help people with dry skin and stuff. Because, again, the desert. What is your preferred form of divination? Okay, so I use two different forms of divination. I use, here we go, show and tell time. Oracle cards. These are the only oracle cards I've really worked with since I've come back to the craft, and I absolutely love them. I am so connected to them. It's not even funny. They're called the Enchanted Oracle, if you're interested. And basically, here's one. This is Tattered Dreams. And then, of course, we got Gothic. They're just absolutely, oh, there's a little shine on there. Absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous imagery on these. I'm not, and there we go, Lavender Moon. You know, they're just really good for me. They really speak to me, they really help. And I went through just recently, and I'm not going to get into details about it, but recently over the last 6 to 8 weeks, I've went through the most difficult, emotional, I mean, crazy I've ever been in my life. Worse than my parents passing away. I mean, very emotional. And these cards and my deity and my craft got me through it. So the other one, whoop, I didn't bring, just hold on 1 second. I thought I was prepared for everything, but I guess not. So the other one that I use is pendulum. And this is the one that I use the most. This is an amethyst pendulum. And as you can see, I'm barely moving and she is just singing. I don't know if you can see it, but it's very, very light amethyst. Amethyst is not only my birthstone, but it's very, very resonates well. So this particular stone, it works beautifully. Now the pendulum board I made, and if you want to know more about it, Sunshine Morning Ray has it on her channel. I was trying to buy one from her, but she wasn't making any. There wasn't any up. So I was like, I gotta have one. So I took apart her video and I watched it very carefully and I pieced it together and I made my own. So this is mine. Those are glistening on here. So it's a good size board. It's about 12 inch by 12 inch. And it's got the yes and the no and the not, you know, not, no, does not want to answer, maybe. And then I found a picture that I really love. This is also on my computer, of a witch with her cat with purple eyes. So it's very beautiful. This one took me about 2 weeks to make, and basically it was just a layer after layer after layer of shellac that I put on it. So that's what I use for my divination, and I love it. Absolutely love it. Okay. Yeah, so much for being a short video. What element do you work with the most? I work with all, for the most part, mainly fire. Even though, you know, I don't do the astrological signs, like I'm a Pisces, but I don't like large bodies of water. I don't enjoy swimming. The only water I get into is a hot tub or the tub or the shower. So I'm not really a water person, but I can be emotional. But I'm also a planner, and I guess my moon is in Capricorn, is what I was told, so I'm a planner. It's confusing to me. I don't know. So elements themselves, basically a lot fire. I love to burn things. I love fire pits, burn piles. You know, if I can't burn it, I ain't happy. I lose myself when I'm doing spells. I'm surrounded by the candles, and just the firelight is really soothing for me. It really gets me into the right zone. So fire tends to be the most that I work with. And then the second would be earth. Very grounded, I have a garden, so I like to go out and I get my hands into my garden, and you know, and I just love that feel. So, and some of the spells that I do, I'm going to do one as we get closer to Beltane. It has a lot to do with my garden and with earth magic as well. So, so I work with fire and earth basically. If you threw a party, which of the YouTube witches would you invite? All of you. It ain't a party if you're all not there. All right. So lots of alcohol, lots of music, lots of fun. And it, everybody I subscribe to, everybody. So, you know, the more witches, the better. That's what I always have to say. And the last one is, what is your witchy goals for the new year? So that would be this year, because this was 2016. So this year. So basically my witchy goals are my life goals. I'm a witch, so everything I do in my life is witchy. My goals are to work on myself. I've been losing weight, working on this temple that the goddess, you know, temple of the goddess. Trying to really love myself and really, you know, it's a lot of internal shadow work and a lot of stuff that I've been working on myself with. So I want to get my strength back, my intuition back, get that strong power that I had before. I'm getting that back. That's pretty much it. I mean, everything else is just basically, you know, just keep witching, learning more. I'm always, every day, have to learn something new every day. Read something or hear something or YouTube something or, you know, like yesterday I saw a video on crafting, sculpting your own statue with clay. So I'm going to go buy some clay in the next week or so. And I'm going to start sculpting. I don't have statues for my matron and patron because I can't find them. So I want to make them. So that's my goals. I just want to be, and this here, YouTube, everybody here. This was another thing that I was wanting to do this year. And I'm so glad I was able to finally do it, is to do a YouTube video and to put it out there and to put myself out there on the YouTube. I'm not afraid of bullies. I ain't afraid of trolls. Y'all don't scare me. I don't care. Just, you know, it was just that I just didn't feel that it was a self-confidence thing. I didn't feel like I had anything to give to the YouTube community. So, I've been feeling really great since I put my first video up. I've gotten some really good, great feedback, sweet feedback. I was like almost in tears. It was so awesome. Noah, you know, Owlvine, Random Witch, hugs. So yeah, so this is another big thing that I have this year is to do as many videos as I can on different things. So that's it for the 16 questions. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna post the 16 questions in the description box down here somewhere. And anybody that watches my video, tag, you're it. Okay, so, and of course, let me know you do it because I want to see it as well. I think that's it. You know, for the most part, I just wanted to do a second video. Actually got a book together with a whole bunch of ideas of different videos that I'm going to do, kind of showing all the different ways that I practice, because I realize there's a few things that I do that are completely different that I've never heard anybody else do. So I'm willing to share that and just see where this takes me. And just to meet as many witches as possible, because the hermit that I am wants to meet people like you, because I'm an introvert like crazy. So anyway, I think that's everything. And again, I hope you like my video. I hope you guys have an absolutely great day, great night, great afternoon, wherever you are in the world watching this, and have an absolutely fantastic time. Talk to you later.